At dusk, we arrived at the rendezvous and hove to under the welcome cover of the deepening night. Now began the most trying ordeal of all, waiting through the long, nerve-straining silence for H hour. Swept the enemy beaches with brooms of fire. And by dawn, the smaller landing craft were in the water, ready to take on their cargoes of infantry. While the big guns fought it out with hidden Nazi shore batteries, our first wave moved in. From the skies, hundreds of planes provided air cover for the seaborne invasion below. While operating inshore, fast rocket boats showered the enemy with their rain of death. CVPs moved in close to the obstacle barricade and dropped their ramps. Through deadly enemy machine gun and mortar fire, the troops waded through deep water to the shore. Many never reached it. The larger LCIs came shouldering in with more infantry to reinforce our hard-won foothold. Coast Guard rescue cutters were already going about their grim business of picking up the wounded and the dead. During those next violent days, while we were fighting to extend our gains, thousands of men and vast quantities of supplies and equipment were shuttled in from the sea. We landed more medical field units. The severely wounded were carried to the relative safety of outlying hospital ships and transports. Thank you. The two-way traffic never stopped. The wounded going out, the ever-growing tide of more men and material pouring in. When the enemy had been pushed back from the beaches, the mammoth LSTs came lumbering ashore with their tons of heavy equipment. Beachhead to Berlin was established. The invasion surged farther inland, gaining power as it went. Now the troops were on their own. As the Allied armies rolled forward, thousands of German prisoners were filtered to the rear to wait until we had time to evacuate them. Scores of our older merchant vessels had been scuttled to form protective breakwaters against the treacherous seas. Now, the full fury of a channel gale swept our invasion coast. Had taken its toll, adding to the high price we had already paid in men and ships. The Flying Angel was among our Coast Guard losses. Young Bill Jackson will never sing in your choir again. I have already written his parents. That's the hardest part of our task. Those last letters we of the Chaplain Corps must write. There are so many deeds of courage and sacrifice that cannot be measured in mere words. They must be recorded by a much greater power than is ours. So much for now, old friend. The great crusade of liberation is well begun. I myself have been more than fortunate. My prayer is that I will always be with my boys in whatever trials may lie ahead.